So there's a sense in which a set cannot be everything. It's not really correct to say that a set has a boundary, but it can't be all-inclusive. One thing that you can do is actually define a process on sets that and so this is the process that takes A to A union the singleton of RA. I'll call this EA. So let's call this the Russell expansion of A. Well, the point is that for every A, EA strictly contains A. So you can imagine iterating this expansion process. And you get a transfinite dynamics. On sets. And I think that there are many obvious mathematical questions that can be raised about this dynamics. So in particular, can you start with a set and eventually engulf the entire universe of all sets? But I'll leave that as a question for the cocktail hour. All right, so this picture is the most important picture of the talk. It suggests the idea of some analogy with experience on the one hand and awareness. All right, well, that's a very crude model for consciousness. But as you see already, it allows for iteration. And there are many speculations about awareness of awareness and higher order extrapolations thereof. So once you have arrived at this setup, it's natural to ask whether there are other operators which have properties similar to this operator that I'm calling the Russell operator. Okay, so after all, what's so canonical about this construction? What are the main properties? Well, R is defined by a proposition. For every A, RA is not an element of A. And then there's another property which is very easy to check. That is that for every A, A is not an element of RA. So in the interest of time, I'll just leave that to you to check from the definition. Okay. So if this really naive model of consciousness is to have any usefulness, we should be able to find other operators that have these three properties. So, say an abstract consciousness operator is only to be taken within the context of this elementary model. This would be a construction on sets such that K is defined by a biological proposition and of course here Mark's question is relevant because you have to know what do you mean by a logical proposition and then you want to have that for every set A KA is not an element of A. Notice here that K now is automatically a subset of A because it's the elements of A that satisfy the proposition. So I want this second property of R to hold in generality, and then I want this third property to hold. Right. All right, well, if you look at these properties, it's not obvious that there are any examples. Okay, but I can give you one construction.
Sorry, does the first axiom force k squared to be the same as k?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, in fact, if you have any two operators that are defined by a proposition, the property that their product is the same as the intersection. So that's a more general statement.